We love recognizing military heroes here at CAKE, and we have the privilege of sharing this really touching story of a search for an old comrade. A Vietnam veteran who lives in California has always wanted to find a military buddy of his, so he tried to find his friend with a letter. The handwritten note went to a man here in Wichita, and it reads that he's looking for a guy named Jimmy Lee Porter. All he knows is that Jimmy worked for Cessna. He would be in his early 70s and was stationed as a drafter in Fort Hood between 1966 and 1968. The letter itself went to this man, James Porter. He has a similar background to the Jimmy that the guy in California was looking for. The younger man here, James, was touched by what was sent his way, but it's not him. He wanted to help, though. The veteran from California, his name is John Wash, and he planned to come to Wichita this month. So James, the guy here, knew that time was of the essence. James did everything in his power to reach the right people. He contacted the Veterans Administration, the VFW, American Legion, even contacted me, as my dad is also a Vietnam veteran and a leader of a group in the area. James had worried, though, that maybe the man that he was looking for had passed away. But then, days into the search, James found Jimmy. This week, Jimmy and John, they reunited, two friends who have not seen each other for 50 years, but certainly remembering each other in a very tough time. And as many as you know, military veterans, especially those from the Vietnam War era, they were not given the warmest of welcome homes. But these two, they talked to each other, with each other for hours. The three of them all together sharing an evening. The young James here on the left, John Walsh, or Wash, from California, that guy there in the middle, and the man they were looking for on the right in the orange, Jimmy Lee Porter. James and Jimmy, they share more than a name. Kind of interesting. They both have loved ones, immediate family members named Mary, and they both actually had worked for Cessna. James, the younger gentleman, shares these photos with me, saying you can tell the bond between these two guys. They've served in the war together, everything very strong. Stronger, he thinks, than many family relationships. I'm told, though, that this is the second time that James got a letter from John. But James wasn't sure what to think about that first one that was sent to him about 15 years ago. Certainly, the birth of social media helped him in this search, leading to this really incredible reunion. James says that he's glad John persisted, jotting down everything that he could to do to find his friend. And James tells me, after he heard, you know, the stories here, that he says that he understands the bond that these two soldiers have had with one another, one of the greatest experiences of his adult life, and he said that they were tickled pink to reminisce with one another, and certainly a small bit of time that he says can really change someone's life. We'll be right back.